Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to download and install Git in Windows. So let's get started.
So first thing, just Google download Git. You'll be getting the official website. Just click on this, and here we'll be having option for different operating system. We are going to do it for Windows, so just click on it, and we'll be getting the Windows setup for 32-bit OS as well as 64-bit. I'm using 64-bit, so I will just click on this, and the download will be getting started. So it is just about 65 MB in size, so just be patient till then. So once the download is complete, just open it, just click on yes, and in the setup dialog box click on next, and this is going to be the location where Git is going to get installed. If you want to change it, just click on browse and change it. So once you are good with the location, just click on next, and these are fines. If you want to have a desktop application, you can just have it and make sure that you are checking these things, and I'm fine with this. I'll just click on next. This is fine. Next, next, just leave it with the default ones over here. And the installation process will begin. So once the install is complete, you can just uncheck this and just click on finish. Now to check whether Git has been properly installed, just open your command prompt and run the command git space hyphen hyphen version, and you'll be getting the Git version over here. And in case if you haven't got this version, what you need to do is just search for environment. You'll be getting the edit the system environment variables. Open it, environment variables, and here if you go under path, under system variables or user variables, click on edit. Here you can see by default this path has been added for me. And in case if you are getting some errors, like you are not getting the version over here, what you need to do is you need to just add this particular path. Okay, so it's going to be the default path and then the bin folder as well as the cmd folder. So you need to just copy these two paths and you need to just add it. Like you need to click on this edit new and paste those paths. Just click on OK. So you need to just do this, and by default the path comes, and in case if you are getting error, just do this. So that's the video guys. I hope you have found this useful. Do check the playlist. I've done a lot of videos in programming, CRUD operations, AI tools. So subscribe me. Thanks for watching.